Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I am here with a new topic, that is microorganisms, a friend and a foe. Okay, so this is the chapter of class 8th science syllabus. So let us know what is microorganisms. So we have seen many organisms in our nature, like plants, animals, human beings, insects. Okay, so there are one more type of organism. They are known as microorganisms. So let us see what these microorganisms are. So microorganisms, the living organisms which cannot be seen by our naked eyes, are known as microorganisms. Okay, these are the type of organisms which we cannot see by our own eyes. Okay, for example, bread getting spoiled as it is covered with grayish white patches. You may have noticed many times that our bread is getting spoiled and we see many black color spots on it. Okay, these are nothing but the microorganisms. So let's see, these microorganisms are small in size and they cannot be seen with the naked eyes. Why we cannot see by our own eyes? These microorganisms cannot be seen by our naked eyes. Why? Because of their small size. Okay, you know what is the size of the microorganisms? They are 10 to the power of minus 9. That they are so small. Okay, so but some of the fungus grow on bread and can be seen with a magnifying glass. Here I told you the bread is getting spoiled. That is nothing but the fungus. Okay, it is a type of microorganism. We will come back to it later on. So it grows on the bread and can be seen with a magnifying glass. So this fungus can be seen by a magnifying glass. So let's go to the next topic, that is types of microorganisms. So basically there are four types of microorganisms. The first one is bacteria, second one is fungi, third one is protozoa, and the fourth one is algae. Okay, so bacteria are something which causes typhoid and TB. TB is nothing but tuberculosis. Similarly, fungi, I have told you about the fungi here also. So the fungi causes ringworm. You may have noticed about the ringworm. Okay, so similarly, protozoa causes dysentery and malaria. Dysentery is nothing but loose motions. Similarly, algae, it also causes fever, vomiting, etc. You may have noticed this algae, because it is a type which where we can see this algae a little bit. Okay, so you may have seen the ponds which is covered with a greenish layer above it. That greenish layer is nothing but the algae. As soon as we come in contact with that water, the water in which the presence of algae is there, that causes us fever, vomiting and whatever, etc. Okay, then I have told you that because of these small size of these microorganisms, it cannot be seen by our naked eyes. But we can see this through a microscope. Okay, a picture of the microscope will be displayed. So this microscope helps us to see these types of microorganisms and how they can cause the different types of diseases. Okay, next, moving on to the next one. The fifth, there is one more type of microorganism that is known as viruses. Okay, so this is not included in the type of microorganisms just because these viruses are a bit different type of microorganisms. So why they are different type of microorganisms? The question comes here. Okay, so the answer to this question is, viruses, as they are present on any of the surface like table, on the floor, or any of the surfaces, they will be like a dead organism. Okay, so they will be as a dead organism. They will be not at all active. So as soon as they comes in the contact with the organisms which is alive, like human beings, plants, animals, whatever it is, they become super active and they go on spreading diseases. How they will spread diseases? Because as these viruses comes in contact with any organisms which is any living organism, they inside the cells of the living organisms, they start reproducing again and again. Okay, so this helps in causing diseases like common cold, cough, polio, chickenpox, and many other types of diseases. Okay, so here next comes, where do microorganisms live? Okay, so the answer to this question is, they live in all type of environment. Okay, all type of environment means whether it is a hot environment, whether it is a cold environment, they can survive in each and every type of environment. Okay, so here one thing we have to keep in our mind, that the organisms, the microorganisms which live in the hot environment cannot survive in the cold environment, and the organisms which are living in the cold environment cannot survive in the hot environment. Okay, so they also live inside the bodies of animal, including humans. Okay, it means the microorganisms also exist in our bodies. The next comes, microorganisms and us. Okay, so the microorganisms and us, what is the relation between our microorganisms and us? So there is a relationship between microorganisms and us. These microorganisms can be friendly to us as well as they can be harmful to us. So how they are friendly and how they are harmful, we will come to this point in our next video. So till then, don't forget to like my video and also share and subscribe to my channel, and also comment down below if you have any doubt regarding this. Thank you.